But this is a developer conference, and the coolest thing about this is that we're bringing the same concept to the API. Many of you have already been building agent-like experiences on the API. For example, Shopify's Sidekick, which lets you take actions on the platform. Discord's Clyde lets Discord moderators create custom personalities for. And Snap's My AI, a customized chatbot that can be added to group chats and make recommendations. These experiences are great, but they have been hard to build, sometimes taking months, teams of dozens of engineers. There's a lot to handle to make this custom assistant experience. So today, we're making that a lot easier with our new Assistance API. The Assistance API includes persistent threads, so they don't have to figure out how to deal with long conversation history, built-in retrieval, code interpreter, a working Python interpreter in a sandbox environment, and of course, the improved function calling that we talked about earlier. So we'd like to show you a demo of how this works. And here is Raman, our head of developer experience. Welcome, Raman.
Thank you, Sam. Good morning. Wow, it's fantastic to see you all here. It's been so inspiring to see so many of you infusing AI into your apps. Today, we're launching new modalities in the API, but we are also very excited to improve the developer experience for you all to build assistive agents. So let's dive right in. Imagine I'm building Wanderlust, a travel app for global explorers, and this is the landing page. I've actually used GPT-4 to come up with these destination ideas, and for those of you with a keen eye, these illustrations are generated programmatically using the new DALL-E 3 API available to all of you today. So it's pretty remarkable. But let's enhance this app by adding a very simple assistant to it. This is the screen. We're going to come back to it in a second. First, I'm going to switch over to the new assistant's playground. Creating an assistant is easy. You just give it a name, some initial instructions, a model. In this case, I'll pick GPT-4 Turbo. And here, I'll also go ahead and select some tools. I'll turn on code interpreter and retrieval and save. And that's it. Our assistant is ready to go. Next, I can integrate with two new primitives of this assistant's API, threads and messages. Let's take a quick look at the code. The process here is very simple. For each new user, I will create a new thread. And as these users engage with their assistant, I will add their messages to these threads. Very simple. And then I can simply run the assistant at any time to stream the responses back to the app. So we can return to the app and try that in action. If I say, hey, let's go to Paris. All right, that's it. With just a few lines of code, users can now have a very specialized assistant right inside the app. And I'd like to highlight one of my favorite features here, function calling. If you have not used it yet, function calling is really powerful. And as Sam mentioned, we're taking it a step further today. It now guarantees the JSON output with no added latency. And you can invoke multiple functions at once for the first time. So here, if I carry on and say, hey, what are the top 10 things to do? I'm going to have the assistant respond to that again. And here, what's interesting is that the assistant knows about functions, including those to annotate the map that you see on the right. And so now all of these pins are dropping in real time here. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And that integration allows our natural language interface to interact fluidly with components and features of our app. And it truly showcases now the harmony you can build between AI and UI, where the assistant is actually taking action. But next, let's talk about retrieval. And retrieval is about giving our assistant more knowledge beyond these immediate user messages. In fact, I got inspired and I already booked my tickets to Paris. So I'm just going to drag and drop here this PDF. While it's uploading, I can just sneak peek at it. Very typical United flight ticket. And behind the scene here, what's happening is that retrieval is reading these files, and boom, the information about this PDF appeared on the screen. And this is, of course, a very tiny PDF, but assistants can parse long-form documents from extensive text to intricate product specs, depending on what you're building. In fact, I also booked an Airbnb, so I'm just going to drag that over to the conversation as well. And by the way, we've heard from so many of you developers how hard that is to build yourself. You typically need to compute your embeddings. You need to set up chunking algorithm. Now, all of that is taken care of. And there's more than retrieval. With every API call, you usually need to resend the entire conversation history, which means, you know, setting up a key value store. That means like handling the context window, serializing messages, and so forth. That complexity now completely goes away with this new stateful API. But just because OpenAI is managing this API does not mean it's a black box. In fact, you can see the steps that the tools are taking right inside your developer dashboard. So here, if I go ahead and click on threads, this is the thread I believe we're currently working on. And see, like, these are all the steps, including the function.